everyone. It is Cinnamon Cooney, your Art Sherpa, ready to guide you step by step through this beautiful, uplifting angel painting. All you've got to do is get your brushes and your paints and come back and meet me at this easel right now. Let's open our hearts. We're going to access our art. Hey everybody, I am so glad you could make it. If you're returning here to the art studio to paint with me again, it is so good to see you. I hope you're doing really great in your life and you're enjoying your art journey. If you're brand new, this is an exciting day to show up. We're going to be painting Angel Heart, which is one of my angel paintings. I've been painting angels my whole life. I like them. I like the idea of them. I believe in them, so I paint them. But I'm not expecting anyone else to. I'm just saying that's my own personal groove I have in life. I believe in human angels, people that come into our lives that bring goodness into it. And I believe in the angels that can't see that save me from my bad decisions in my car. So if you have one of those angels, this will be about one of those kinds of angels we're painting today. Our materials are going to be, let's start with the brushes. I got a whole little grip of brushes here, assorted brushes. A 1 inch, either a filbert or square, but something about an inch wide. Some half inch wide squares, but you could get away if you just had an angle shader. Some quarter inch brights and some details. These are the little pointed ones, okay? We'll always have a materials list. Go by our Pinterest page, our Heart Party webpage, our Facebook page. We start putting up those supplements as we release these. And there's always even more and more help as time goes by. We keep trying to think of ways to make that lesson easier. You're gonna need a 16 by 20 pre-gessoed canvas. You can get those at PAX. I got this one at Hobby Lobby, but the craft stores have them and they have PAX and they have deals and just go by. Somebody's got some in. Paint wise, let's see, what are we going to need? We're going to need cad yellow, phthalo blue, dioxazine purple, yellow ochre, cad red, and titanium white. And of course today, get your special happy cup. This is my special happy cup. And I found this, they didn't write me or anything. I just found this and I thought I'd share this with you. Check out this cool lemonade. This was in the health food store. So it's healthy, right? It was, but it made it, I thought it would be special, and it's a little special something to drink, and it says Belle Noir Fruit Farms Elderflower and Rose Lemonade. And I thought, what could make my painting time more special than that? And do that. Pick something up that makes your painting time feel special. A special cup, a special drink, your favorite Kona bean coffee, just whatever it is that you've got that's going to make you feel good and special. I'm going to pick up my 1 inch brush. Now listen guys, I'm going to paint a thing, you're going to paint a thing, I'm going to paint a thing, you're going to paint a thing. This is actually a fully guided tutorial. So all you got to do is follow along with me and you're going to get a result, all right? So let's get our brush wet because acrylic paint needs water. And we're going to start with a little white, titanium white, over to our yellow. Just like this right here. You can see this in the palette cam. All right, I'm going to make this nice, soft, ducky yellow. And I'm going to come over here off center, right, about a hand over and 4 inches down. And I'm going to make a general circle like that. That's how brave I am. Just a general circle like that. Guys, all right, one of the things I want to suggest to you when you're dealing with circle is some of you might be like, I can't even make a circle. If you're having trouble getting your circle, try to think of it as something else, like perhaps a clock or a wheel that might help kick your brain over. But know this, even if a circle is a challenge today, right, over time, you are connecting neurons in your brain. You're actually repairing and strengthening the neuroplasticity in your brain. Those pathways are connecting and you're making headway there. And I really like this canvas, actually. This is the one I got from Hobby Lobby. I'm really liking this one. It's coated with something that just is very friendly to the paint. Just FYI, that I'm noticing as we're painting and I'm sharing with you. I might go back by there today and get some more and we'll talk about that more specifically. So see, I've just got this multi-tonal yellow. Do you see this right here? This isn't about making an exact circle. And you guys, as you paint, you'll get better and better at the circles. Even if the circles are eluding you today, You get the benefits from painting, no matter what the results are. All right, so your only job is to just follow along with me, suspend disbelief that you can't paint, and you're gonna get a benefit from this art with me. Now I'm gonna mix a little red and yellow, it's gonna make an orange. And I'm gonna come over here to my right-hand side, all right? I'm going to paint this up. I'm not gonna go all the way over to this side. I'm actually going to be staying on this right hemisphere of the canvas, okay? Now the other thing I want you guys to realize is that I paint fairly quickly. I've been doing it for a while. I have a lot of confidence in what I'm doing. So my decisions are fast and my paint remains wet while I am working. All right, so I get a nice blended effect, but you may be painting at a different speed. You know what that means? That you're just painting at a different speed. It's not a big deal at all, okay? There's no speed component to painting. I think a lot of people paint oils. I got some more just straight cad red that I'm working here. I think a lot of people are painting oils because they don't dry and the paint allows them to work at a speed that is fully enjoyable for them, okay? But I really like acrylics, and guess what? They have two solutions for that. They have slow drying mediums that you can add to your paint to slow down the drying time. And they have golden opens or other specialty paints who have slow drying times. Okay, so like the paint is designed to dry slower. Either one of those solutions will really work for you if you find that for you to enjoy your painting, you're painting at a pace where the paint is drying. Don't worry about that. Now, I am painting pro paints here, kiddos. I am painting Liquitex heavy bodied, and I've got some Golden in my collection, and I have some Matisse Derivan paints. I love all of those companies. They may be competitive with each other, but I am not competitive within my own studio about this stuff, so I like all three. But what I want to say to you when you're painting is please pick the best paint that you and your budget can afford. So I get a little bit of white there. I'm going to lighten some of this up out here. All right. Going to add some white out here. Strengthen this up. See where I'm putting some white out here? Ooh, this is so nice and multi-tonal awesomeness. I might want to get it up here because we're going to see more of that. All right. See how that's looking? Now, for fun, I'm going to go get some purple. So buy the best paint that you can afford. And if you got to do Liquitex Basics, do Liquitex Basics or the Windsor & Newton Galleria or Artist Loft. Try to avoid really off unknown brands. Sometimes those companies use really strange binders and vegetable pigments. And I have to tell you, I have run into these paints. They are a misery. I'm a very talented artist. I have painted in coffee. It's on the channel, on the time lapse. You can watch me do it. I can paint nearly everything. But those vegetable paints, oh, I'll tell you what, I really wanted to hop up and down and have a whole moment about those paints. I am really liking this canvas, like a lot. Let's see what this is. Really like this. I'm going to go out today and I'm going to buy some more of this is what I'm going to do for next painting because I really dig this canvas. Got it at Hobby Lobby. It was their two-pack deal. Whatever that was. I don't even know. I was just in there, you know, buying that burlap canvas from that earlier episode and was like, oh, I need a couple more 16 by 20s. They have some in and just got a couple of these. And that's how it happened. No real master plan there. Right? None. I'm going to get a little more white just up here. Add that into my little purple. Create some little dynamicness to it. Isn't that pretty? Now you could, if your house required it, take that all the way around. But I like to have a lot of color. Right? And so rinse that brush out really well. Use a paper towel or a rag. And I am going to make a little turquoise, which is going to be a little bit of blue with a titch of yellow, okay, and some white. Coming around here, look at that go. outside edge. Need a little more paint on my brush, a little less water. These are little adjustments that you make as you go. Trust me. You make these little adjustments as you're painting. See, and I paint so fast that my purple here is going to come work up into this. That's my speed. That may not be your speed. Your speed does not need to be my speed. My speed is not a sign of success. It is a sign of just the way my brain works. And also the years in which I have painted. That is what is going on with me. Okay? So you don't need to be feeling at all weird about what you've got going on with your speed based on mine. I hope, like, when you guys saw me paint with my daughter, that really brought that home, which is that she has her own little path that she's on, that she's painting on. And that's what she's doing. And she will get it done when she gets it done. You know? We can use a hair dryer to sort of even things out, but really? You know? I'm going to get some just yellow here. Work this right here where the yellow is budding up into the blue. I'm going to make sure that my halo has like sort of a feeling to it. Play with this. Enjoy. This is teaching you a lot about mixing colors, believe it or not. So if you're very new to painting, this is like a fabulous crash course in mixing colors that is actually fun. And while you guys are speeding around your canvas going, oh my gosh, I'm so glad I can pause and fast forward her, which is what I really love about YouTube. I love that you guys have the control to just put the stop button on me or just put the I don't need to hear about this part of your life button on me and speed me up. That is fantastic about this place as a resource. Oh, that's... What is an elderflower, internet? Don't even... What is an elderflower? Comments, tell me. What's an elderflower? I don't know. But you know what it is? It's tasty. Oh, if you like this glass, I got this from Pier 1 Imports. They had some really fun coffee mugs and glasses that I treated myself to for the studio. They're the mommy mugs. And believe you me, the kids are always like, I want mommy's mug. And I'm like, mommy's mug. If you're like me and you painted very quickly and ready to go on to the next thing, hair dryer. Here's your hair dryer tip. About 6 inches back, move it around quickly all around your canvas. It is not about the heat, it is about the wind. So put it on your low setting and your high. You'll know it's dry when it's not so shiny, and also when you touch it, it shouldn't get on your hand. So that would be another clue that that it's dry. I'm gonna rinse out my brush, try to get all the paint out of it. I do it all the time, but you should not leave your brushes in water because the wood will swell and it will mess with the ferrule, which is the metal part of the brush, and it'll crack all this treatment off. And I'm painting with Creative Mark because I can get those, but there's a whole bunch of fantastic brushes out there. I am trying to get my Amazon affiliate store stuff together so you can just like one click get all the basic stuff you need for your studio. And I'm trying to make sure I'm doing different product lines. So it's not just pro, it's some entry level paints. It's not just pro brushes, it's some entry level brushes. So I'm respecting everybody's budget because hey, we all have a different budget. I'm going to draw her in this blue chalk. You use white chalk because the blue is going to tint my paint, which won't bother me, but would bother you a lot. But I'm going to turn this a little bit so you can have a better view on it. And we're going to talk about gesture. Gesture sketching is kind of like a stick figure, but it's about the movement and flow of that figure. And it helps people who are really good at doing dynamic images create those. This hat is just making me crazy. I don't know. I got it back out and then I'm like, no. What is happening with my hair? Back in the thing. All right, so here we go. The gesture of this, I'm going to start this just a bit below my yellow line. I'm just going to show you. It's a curve. All right. Do you see that? This is a curve. That's the feel of her that I want to have going. All right. And I'm going to draw a little head shape here tried to do this the other day, and for some reason I got just giant with the head. I don't know what was going on with me. I got just giant. This is an egg shape, right? Then I'm going to have a little neck come down here. Be longer with these shapes, right? Then you would just maybe incline to do. You want longer lines. That's what creates flow. It's a good thing to know. Can you see that right there? There you go. All right. Now I'm going to come out, make a shoulder shape. See, that's about three fingers right there. And I'm going to flow over here. I'm just going to show that this is what's happening. And I just want to know it later when I'm painting. I'm going to come out here and make an S. Then I know I've got skirt here and I've got some skirt here. So now I know, let's see if you can see all those lines. I might need to do these down here in white. Ah, and I'll show you guys. Now for me, the white on there was better. So you see those lines where I came down off her shoulder and I just swirled it over here and I came over this wide shoulder and I swirled it down here. This is an abstract piece. This is going to teach some fundamentals of what we're doing in figure drawing, but what we're not going to worry about is being realistic. And remember, like, say you were doing NEMA therapy, which is that art therapy that is for people who are suffering from Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, kids dealing with stuff on the autistic spectrum. This is about connecting communication centers of the brain. Think about the power of that for a second. Art is another process of creating communication. So if those things are damaged, this is a fantastic way to get in there and heal. Good thing to talk about when you're painting angels, right? The other thing that I'm going to draw in here is I'm going to draw in, so here's the top of her head, right? About two fingers down, I'm going to make an arc come down and a little nose. This is just the eyebrow arch nose. Almost like a little number here, right? I'm going to come back up this side, another little arc. And that's all I'm going to talk about on this whole face shape. I'm not going to tell the whole story. Here's another little mark to let me know where the mouth is. And I've got about a finger here and a finger here. This is all in chalk. Check your dimensions. Make sure you like it. But also remember, it's not about the result. It is about the journey. It's about doing several paintings over time consistently. That's when you're going to see benefits. All right. I'm going to get a, I think I'm going to do this with a half inch bright. Get my brush wet. I'm going to show you my first formula for skin tones. I have, and it's in my wish list, I'm going to be putting it on my site in different places, my favorite book for paint recipes for skin tones and hair color. I'm going to share that with you guys. I'm not going to keep that secret. I absolutely love that. So I've got a little cad here and a little yellow ochre. All right. And I'm going to come get some white. That is the basis for what I'm going to use for these skin tones. And I'm going to come up here, on the top here, come across. This upper half of the head is going to be my lighter color here. I'm going to use all kinds of crazy colors in her face. But I'm going to have a basis of skin tone in there. Look at that. Do you remember those little things that we'd drawn a kid and they had the, what was it? Again, in the comments, it was who was here? Who was it that was here? I don't remember. Uh-oh. Better go draw a clock. I don't remember who was here. But somebody was here. And we drew it as a kid. I'm going to get some of this blue here and bring it over to my peach. You see that I brought some of that over to darken it? And I'm going to come, now it needs to be even darker than that. Let's get some blue to the peach. And you're like, what? That's crazy. It is crazy, but is what we are going to do right here in this eye. We're going to bring it around, come down. You can do this. Don't panic. Don't panic. Don't panic. Whole bottom of the face is going to be like this, okay? Notice I don't really stress about having like perfectly mixed Home Depot little swatches of paint. One of the things that I'm very, gosh, I like this canvas. One of the things that I'm very confident with, one of the things that I feel very good about, is just allowing it to be. Now I know for you fabulous, awesome, beautiful perfectionists, sometimes allowing it to be can be a challenge, and you've got to find the perfection in allowing that. The perfect amount of allowing it to be. Find your space in it. Never fight who you authentically are, guys. Right? That messes with your happiness quotient. If you are not just accepting who you are, that is a formula. See how easy that is? For being really unhappy is what that is. And I would not want that for you. You would not want that for yourselves. I'm going to just come down here on my thin little neck. You know? Like that. Thin little neck for my angel. I'm going to rinse out my brush. Alright. And I think the next thing that I want to do, sort of get some of these blues, some of these colors here, come in here and paint this in. Look at me doing that with my 1-inch brush. One of my tricks is to be, again, not overly specific, to allow the variance of colors. We've got a painting coming up, and there'll be the lesson after this one, and your ability to work through the colors will be your key to feeling like success. This is a fantastic place. This painting is a fantastic painting. I just got some Just Blue there. To just play with the color. See what you like. When does your brain go, yay? Okay. I'm not taking this all the way out to the outer line because I have a plan for the outer line here. Right? A little bit here. I'm just sort of making a leaf shape in the center because I've got to talk about these arms. So I'm leaving about a quarter of an inch between my paint line and my chalk line. Just some decision that I'm making as I'm painting. I find sometimes when I'm painting and talking, I get a little off my process for the painting. And one of my big things to learn was how to keep my painting together when I was painting with you guys. Now I've got some Just Yellow, and I'm going to follow my chalk line. My Just Yellow, and I'm following my chalk line. This would be one of those places that you're really going to notice if you're using a very good paint or a very cheap paint. My paint, because it's manufactured by somebody who cares a lot about their product, the three companies I mention, one thing they all have in common is they all care deeply about their product. The chemists that work there, the marketers that work there, all the people, you can go to their YouTube channels. All three of them have YouTube channels with support tips. That's another reason why I like them. You go to Matisse, they have a YouTube channel on Jerry's Artorama. You go to Liquitex, they have a tremendously supportive YouTube channel. You go to Golden, they have the most factually correct, well-researched YouTube channel ever. To the point where you're like, it's just more than I want to know. But you know what? They're all really there for the people that buy their products. And I like that about them. I like that about them a lot. It's why I feel like I can recommend these different paint brands to you with incredible confidence, because look at how that yellow goes right over the purple. If you are having a terrible time and you're like painting and painting and all you're seeing is the yellow, what you have is a paint without enough pigment, or I hope not, but possibly one of those vegetable dye paint companies. They're like, who knows who they are? I just grabbed some Just Blue there and I'm working it right into my wet paint and coming up. Now, one of the things that I'm also noticing here, we'll go right back to talking about the paint, but one of the things I want you to notice right here, as this paint beautifully covers everything that's underneath it, is that I'm making this line wider and it tapers as it goes up. It's a very important thing that is happening here, okay? Very important thing. I'm gonna get some more Just Blue and work this in here and darken this up. again, getting away with some of the stuff I do because the quality of the materials that I'm using. And I know you guys have budgets. I know you do. Maybe you start out, you know, with a Liquitex basic paint line, right? And then as you can, you upgrade to what you can get. You know, what's on sale. A lot of artists will have a mix and match of paints because you'll catch sales or you'll catch events where everybody will be out of titanium white and only one company will have a tube left. Guess what? You can absolutely mix and match those paints. I paint with those three brands and they're all fantastic. They all give me a good result and I'm getting a little white, a little yellow here and I'm happy with it. Happy with them. They all answer their customer service line. Like, so if you have a question or a problem with your paint, they all answer. That's what they all have in common. And perhaps, you know, in the sense of like paint, they are competitive with each other, but they're only competitive with each other because of their sheer passion for what they do. That is really important in art because as artists, I'm talking soul here, right? See that there? That blending, that effect there. And I just don't worry, I put a little dab here, a little dab there. Right, here we go. Just let it be painterly. It's like messy and free-spirited. Are you seeing this from back there? How is this looking to you? How's it feeling? How are you feeling? Now I'm gonna come and I'm going to take a little bit of my red and maybe a little white, so it'll be a little bit pink. And I'm going to come around this outside. The blue is going to mix in there. And I'm going to come down with this right along here. Maybe grab a little purple in there too to give it some variance and some tonality. I'm going to stop in my yellow line here. Because this arm is about to pass underneath, right? The other arm tells me where it is in relationship to everything that's going on in the painting. Right. Look at that. That's it. We're not really painting an arm. We're just painting a line. We're just enjoying the process. We're just helping our brain heal and grow and find better chemistry, right? Getting good brain chemistry is always fantastic. I'm going to grab some just red and purple. I'm going to come around here. I'm going to work this line. There we go. That's how I come. So I imagine this line continuing. Then I just come here and come down. Fun stuff. Listen, guys. Even if you are doing an art skill that is stressing your skills out, like is beyond your reach right now, do it anyways. Do the painting anyways. Because you will walk away with more than you entered. For sure. For sure. You will walk away with more than you entered, for sure. All right? You will be a better artist. Not every painting is brilliant, too, by the way. Not everything I do is... I had to redo this thing over because I did it once and it was just a giant head. I don't know what was going on. I just got really out of proportion. I was just distracted. I felt better after painting. I felt more grounded and I looked at it and I was like, oh my God, her head is so big. I can't show that. That's too big of a head. I have to redo that. It happens. It happens to me. I'm going to come back up here with some of this purple. It happens to everybody. And you just be okay with the fact that it might be happening to you, okay? You just be all right with that. Rinse that out. Sometimes we need to get a fresh cup of water. I keep one over here so I don't have to totally just walk away. Walk away. Rinse, 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 rinse. Get a sip. Enjoy. Hopefully, you guys are going to tell me who finding him. I'm going to look it up too. And then, why is an elderflower yummy? Need to know that. Share, comment, subscribe, please. Go to the webpage. Share with me your paintings. Tell me your art stories. Go to the Facebook page. Go to the Heart Party page. We're really working on our forum right now, trying to make that awesome. Getting that kind of kit together. Look for what we've got as resources. Tell us what you think. What do you, what you want? Okay, this is going to be heavily hard on your white. You're going to be using up a lot of this, but that's okay. Don't worry about it. I want you to, even though it's messy, even though there might be paint in it, I'm grabbing some white. Okay, I'm coming to the side here. And I'm just coming down. Now, there was some red in that, so there's some pink in that stroke, but I don't worry about it. Pick up some more paint. And I'm coming down. Look at these strokes. I'm just grabbing paint, and I'm just stroking down, implying a skirt, like that. Maybe I'll grab some less yellow here, right here, and come down and add a little streak of yellow to her skirt. Like, maybe she's got a dress of many colors, like Joseph's coat of many colors. I don't know. I don't know. Not messing with you, I'm just saying. Right? I don't ever mess with you. I'm just this is my internal angel. You may have your own internal angel. That may be a human being, that might be a spiritual energy, and I don't ever tell anyone how to think or how to feel. Ever, ever, ever. Wouldn't do it. I'm gonna get some red, mix it with some yellow right there, make some orange, grab some white. I'm gonna add some of that here. In a couple places. Look for holes in your painting. That is a fabulously fun thing to do. And dab around. Try to break patterns. I know you guys have said it's so hard to break patterns. Somebody just compared it in the comments to childbirth. And I was like, now is that Beyonce in the luxury delivery room with an epidural childbirth? Or is that with a doula and a midwife in a tub and all your girlfriends chanting childbirth? Because those are very different childbirths. It's very, they're both difficult. They're both absolutely difficult. But they have different challenges to them. And I'm just trying to get a baseline for what kind of challenge we were facing. I may only be making myself laugh. I'm not really sure. I'm going to come over here to this side. I've got quite a lot of paint. This is this style of painting, this palette knife painting that's so popular right now. This uses up a lot of paint. And it does require a quality paint to really capture the effect wholly. But don't let what you're painting with, don't let any part of your life hold you back from what gives you joy. Don't cap your joy, right? Don't wait till you're a body weight or, you know, oh my goodness. Like, I hear my girlfriends all the time, when I'm a size 6, I'll do this. You're going to wait to go have fun for clothing size? I love you, girl, but come on. We can't do that. We cannot be waiting for the joy. Don't wait for the joy. All right, the joy needs to be happening right now, right now. I got some white, some yellow, and some blue. I'm gonna come in and streak this in here. Look at that, just lovely. Pick up some more white with all this on there, and I'm gonna come in and I'm gonna tell the story of the skirt between these two things. Don't cap your joy. There's no limit to joy. Art doesn't limit you. Your joy should not be limited. Your joy was not intended to be limited. All right. That's something we do to ourselves. Have fun with that brush stroke. Go. Make a noise if you need to. I do when I need them. Make a noise. Alright, I think I'm going to grab a little purple, maybe even a little blue, and some white for this. Come down here and create that in the dress. Have fun. Okay? You've got a colorful painting underneath. You're not going to be sorry. The paint will layer. Seeing the flow and the beauty of this whole thing is a very exciting time. All right, now I'm gonna need to put out some more white paint. So I'm gonna grab my trusty pro paint, which in this particular case, I'm right now got some golden titanium white, because that is exactly like what I described. Everybody else was out of their tube and I grabbed golden. But you know what, they make a really good white, so I don't ever feel bad about it. And I buy the big tubes. That's what I do. All right, so I'm gonna get my half inch here, and I'm going to kind of put in some wings up here. I'm going to get some just white. All right, I'm going to come right up here at the shoulder. Turn this so you can see this. I'm going to come up, come up, come up, come up, come up. This is fun stuff. Enjoy it. So I don't have to tell the story of every feather. Okay? Don't have to do it. Not telling a story. Every feather. I don't stress when a little blue gets on there, because maybe there's a little blue light in there. I don't know how these wings work. These thought wings, these soul wings, I don't know. I don't have to know. That is not my job. My job is to have hope. And my job is to believe in happiness. And my job is to try to be the kind of person that makes the world a better place. That's my job. That's your job. Right? Service to others is the rent we pay. Okay. I love that. I love that. I love that. I picked up a little bit of that blue and purple, but I don't mind it. It's real pretty. See, doesn't that feel wing-like? Do you feel that sort of energy coming out on that wing? Can you see that? Ooh, can you see it there? It's so awesome. You can do an I did it dance because it's going so well. It's good to dance and it's good to sing. Don't cap your happiness. Don't cap it. I was just talking about that with my mom this morning. Don't cap it. Don't put a limit on joy. It's crazy. All right, I'm going to come up this side. I'm going to make a similar arc. Look at that. Just drawing the wings. This is not about perfection. It is about completing. You paint with a lot of beautiful colors, and you paint with a lot of beautiful heart. You're going to find people, they respond to it. All right, guys? They respond to the love and the intent on the inside. And if you're trapped in there and are having trouble, maybe you're painfully shy, right? Maybe you're painfully shy and you just can't get what you have going on inside out. You can tell the world what's happening in you here. This is a communication that's universal. Everybody will know what you meant. You know, maybe you have had something happen. Maybe you've gone through stroke. Maybe you've gone through something that's life-changing. You know, maybe your brain is differently abled and is doing something special, but it's hard to talk to people about what you're going through. You can tell them through art. Okay? You can show them your heart, the truth of your spirit, your purpose, your meaning through this art. And they cannot deny it. It tells its truth right there. Look at that. Don't you feel that? Beautiful energy, that beautiful energy in your life, that beautiful energy in your canvas. The slippy, slippy hat that I like so much, but I keep wearing it. Because a lot of the loopsy things, slippy. All right, I'm going to rinse my brush. I'm really liking that. Wasn't Where's Waldo? Who was it? Who was the guy with the little... Who was it? I'm about to draw it in a Sharpie. You know, this guy. And he'd be like on a wall, and he'd have hands. Right? Like this. What was that guy? Comments. Help me out, because I'm completely freaking out over it. Like I'm messing up. I got crazy hair, because I can't handle it. You ever get that in your head? Something you cannot remember. And you're like, what was it? All right, we're going to paint in this. We're going to come in. I'm going to get some just white and yellow. I'm going to come around here just to the inside. I'm going to leave that little green right there. I'm going to brighten this up. Grab a little more white. Brighten this up. Okay. And come to the outside, just a little bit of blue. Maybe add a little yellow to it. I want a little more greenishness to it. I'm just trying to tell the story of what's happening here. Maybe a little blue down here. Sort of strengthen this up. Some streakiness happened to it. I'm just trying to improve the color story that I'm telling here. You do that same thing. You improve your color story. You tell your color. Tell your truth. You create a mission and a message and tell your truth. Get your voice heard. Everybody deserves to be heard. Doesn't mean everyone will agree with you, but you have the right to be heard. And if you're trapped in there, you definitely have the right to be heard. So please feel free to use these for art therapy. Please, please. Help, help, help. Help others. I just saw a thing. Valspar, so excited about it. Valspar has created glasses that correct for color blindness. So people who cannot see color can see color. It's so beautiful. It's such a beautiful thing. No one at Valspar is watching. But if you were, thank you. Thank you for that. That's a gift to mankind. Guys, see? Angels on Earth. Valspar, check. Angels on Earth for making glasses that help people see. Check, check, check. You know, that's what I mean. Check, check, check. We're going to come around this side and work the red. We're going to get some just red, just some pure red. Because you're going to find that now that this underpainting is here, it just pops. Right? I'm just going to add that. And really, for me, that's all that is necessary here is that to this piece. Maybe I'll grab a little white, though. I like a little pinkness to things. Just take the inside of this arm and pink it up. The outside be the dark red and pink it up right there. Look at that. What it did. Just relax into it. Okay. Now, look for holes in your skirt. It's a good thing to do right now. Look for places that you could add some color. Grab different colors. Just place it around. All right? Just place it around. Place it around. And then I'm going to grab some just white and even work it more through here. Just white. And then you could go back if you're like, no, I really need her to have more of a white skirt, or I need to have any color story you want to tell here. Once you understand the process of how we are doing this painting, guys, you can just make this your own. You are not confined to my vision on this canvas. This is your space. This is your story. See how wonderfully she's coming in? Right? And we're going to finish with the heart last because we always want to finish with heart. So I'm going to rinse this out and I'm going to get a smaller brush. I'm going to get my quarter inch, right? But if you didn't have one, if you weren't able to have one, any detail would work as well, right? This is just about getting a small brush stroke for which I have control. And I'm going to get a little purple, and I'm going to get a little blue, and mix them together. I'm going to grab a little white, which I probably need to put out some more white. Like I said, you'll go through a lot in this painting. Use buy paint from companies that care about you, the consumer. Buy from a company that cares about what your result is. Okay. Don't buy from somebody who's going to put vegetable dyes in a non-polymer pigment and call it acrylic paint. And then you guys send me videos of color just lifting and going crazy. And I'm just like, it's not you. You could totally paint. All right. We're going to come in here. See how this is going. So isn't she pretty already? We're going to come in here. And we're going to follow along with that color and under the nose. Okay. I'm going to get a little more white. Because like I told you, I'm going to do some crazy colors here. I'm not going to use just skin tones. I've got skin tones as a base. But she's special. She is angelic and therefore has special stuff going on. And I'm grabbing some more of that color right there. I'm darkening it up. Having fun. Right here, right? Come along the chin here, this outer line. Yeah, right? Work that here. Work that all down into here. Let me work it down. That, see, that's I'm telling it story. It's when I put the heart in, it tells that story. You know? Tell your stories. Tell your stories. Now, here's an interesting thing. This side I'm going to do even darker. And that side, I'm going to grab some red here. Just to here, just in this space. Grab that there. Let her grab some yellow ochre and some red. What I'm trying to do, and I'm going to come just to here. You could do green. You could just do anything here. Okay? See how that is starting to come together? Be imaginative and whimsical here. Enjoy that side of yourself. Don't cap your creativity. Don't cap your joy. Cap your potential. You know, we're so kind to children. We tell them if they work hard and they dream, they can be anything. But then we tell ourselves that we're out of time. It's over. We missed our bus. We don't deserve that happiness. That is a story people genuinely tell themselves. I don't deserve that good thing in my life. Crazy. But it happens. And you know you do it. You know who you are out there telling yourself a story of not being worthy. Coming up here with little bit of that yellow, and I still had some green in my brush. There's just a dusting of that. Come just the inside, and then right there. But I'm gonna leave some of that there. All right. Now I'm gonna mix some more of my skin color. I love doing these crazy abstracted faces. I love having the time to do it. I love that we're not in a rush to go home. You have everything you need to finish this story. This art story, your story, the way you need to. So I'm going to come here and I'm going to dust right under the nose. Come around under the eye with this pink, letting the green show through. Come around this side. I'm going to come down the neck a little bit. Look at that, just bleeding in there. So nice to do this. You don't know. So blessed to be here with you doing this, telling this amazing story. All right? That's what we're doing. We're telling an amazing story, and we're doing it together. I'm going to come under the eye here with this darker color that I had there. I'll let the blue pick up into it. And that's going to be one of the things is that you used to hear Bob say this, you'll hear different artists say this, there's no mistakes, there's happy accidents. There is a magic synergy, an extraordinary thing that happens when you relax into your canvas, when you relax into your art journey. And it will happen more and more and more. All you've got to do is not give up on yourself. That's all you got to do. Don't give up on you. All right. Okay, so the lips. Sometimes the less story you tell about a feature that we have a lot of internal feelings about, believe you me, lips from birth, we're studying them. Have a lot of internal visual data about lips. Sometimes the less you then say about that subject, kind of like legs, the better. So I'm going to take this square brush. I'm going to kind of blow your mind with this. And I'm going to come right here. And I'm going to just do a couple little upward dabs. And then another. slightly bigger couple upward. That's all I say about lips. That is all I'm going to tell about that. And I'm going to get some white and red, some just pink. Okay. And right here, I'm going to put some of this just pink. And over here, I'm going to put some of this just pink. And that's all I'm going to say about that. Hair. To do the hair, I can see a lot of my paint is wet. So I'm going to need to do the hair dryer. But we got that down. Alright. The next tool I want you to look for is, what brush do you enjoy doing trees with the most? What brush can you go from a thick line to a thin line with a lot of control? Because hair and trees are kind of distant cousins. Excuse me. Hair and trees are kind of distant cousins. And you're going to want to use a similar brush, okay? All better. Almost got some hiccups going, but I am not going to have those. So I'm going to grab a brush, kind of a similar size. I just want to, no, maybe not that one. Yeah, pick just something you feel like, oh, I can get a good result out of this one. This is a half inch that I have. It's a Pro Stroke Power Krill, but I think I gave some of these away by Creative Mark. So I'm going to grab this. Now, I'm going to do a blonde angel. And so that means you're like, wait, you're mixing purple and yellow ochre. Yes, I am. Okay. Yes, I am. That's going to be the deep tone in my hair. Because I'm going to need three tones in my hair. And that's what I'm going to use. And because this is a colorful painting and I am not using black in this, you know, that is a decision that is being made. So I'm going to, from the side of her head, I'm going to give her a side part. I'm going to come around, come down following her line there, okay? Just paint this out. This is the dark shadow of her hair. Again, quality paint will serve me right now. Listen, I know a lot of you guys are going through some stuff while you're painting. This is maybe a painting that you're going to want to do. And I think that is fantastic. I think art heals. I'm always shocked the stuff that art heals people from or gets them through. You, however, are not alone. Many of you are dealing with huge loss or huge illness while painting. And there's a little community of you within our artists. I would love you, if it's something you feel like you could share, to share your stories so that other people who are stuck, who are trapped, and don't know that art could help them the way that it can, could maybe be inspired by you. So go by the Facebook page and share that story. Go by the forum and share that story of how art is helping you get through your trials and tribulations. How is art helping you survive and thrive? Because I know for many of you it really is, and I think that you would be very inspiring and uplifting to each other, and helping others is the rent we pay to be on planet Earth. I love that. That was Cassius Clay. All right, so I'm going to bring her hair down. I want to make a decision, I think, on her. I'm going to give her, I like the bangs that blow over, so I'm going to do that. I'm going to make that line right there. See that right there? The bangs that blow over, and I made this little line. Kind of even cross it down over the eyebrow. And I'm going to have this taper out. This line taper out. Hair is fun. I like hair. I really do. I like creating hairlines. Have a couple come down. I like working contrast. Working dioxazine purple and yellow ochre together to create blonde hair is highly enjoyable. Your angel's hair does not have to be blonde. You could start with burnt sienna and phthalo blue to darken it. where you could start with Mars Black and Phthalo Blue and do the three shades from there. The principle, pay attention to the principle of this. Practice it. Once you have it down, change it up to reflect your internal story. Because again, I'm not trying to teach you to paint like me. I'm trying to teach you to paint like you. That's the journey I'm on with you. I'm trying to help you find you. I already know where I am. Totally centered in that. I'm just trying to reach back and help you find where you are. Alright? So I'm just trying to find the bend and the blow of what I've got going on here, right? Bend and the blow. I'm taking these tendrils off. Maybe another little tendril comes down. I'm pretty sure, all right, that I'm going to want some hair to flow here. You'd be so surprised at how well purple and gold acts for hair. You'd be like, what? That's like a magic trick. And I'll be like, I know it is. Right, we're gonna grab some more. We're gonna tell another little story, a little tendril going here. She's got a little blow in here. Apparently, in the ether where she is, there are celestial winds. That's the story I'm telling. You tell the story that you're telling. And let's not get so mad at each other when we're telling different stories. It's just our story. It's my story. It's your story. It's how we find our place in this crazy, crazy universe. We don't need to get so upset at each other over not agreeing about the story. Let's just allow the story to be. Okay. So she's got some nice angelic hair happening. Look for holes. Go, where do I need more angelic hair? I'm gonna look for some holes right now. Look, put your hand on your hip like a pirate and look for holes is what you should absolutely do, right? I feel like I could, I don't know if I want to tendril something. I know I've got this heart here. Maybe she could have a little tendril, a little bit in the face there. Yeah. All right, I feel like there's a whole little hair story happening right there. So I'm gonna rinse out my brush. Now closest to her head, I'm gonna leave this dark, dark color because that's the shadow of the hair. Our hair has many, many tones, hopefully. I love that the people now with the multi-tonal hair, having grown up when I did, I certainly paved the way for multi-tonal hair. So I'm just putting the yellow ochre just straight on. This works where it's dry. If this were wet, I would just get more of the same color. If you need to hit it with a hair dryer, hit it with a hair dryer, just depending on where you're at. You know, I'm not even going to worry about some of the colors being in this hair. Like if I had another color, like a red or a blue, because she can have multicolored hair. She's celestial. She's an interdimensional being. So she can just pretty much be any way, right? The interdimensional beings can be any old way they need to be. I'm not in charge of that. You know. Don't worry, guys, because I also kind of believe in mermaids and unicorns and all sorts of things. I am a fanciful person that believes in a kind universe with a plan. It's a personal choice that I have made to do that and to look for the things that make me feel like there's hope and order, painting being one of those things. One of the things that you'll learn when you paint a long time is that there's a lot of ways to get there. There's a lot of ways to get to centered. There's a lot of ways to get to serene. There is a lot of ways, a lot of methods, a lot of techniques, a lot of skills to arrive to someplace. And so now I'm much less inclined to tell somebody else that my way is the only way to get somewhere. My personal choice. Like that. See, her blonde hair is coming together. She's beautiful. She's ethereal. She's full of hope and healing and compassion and connecting human beings in a real and powerful way. So now I'm going to grab some white and some yellow. Some white and some yellow. Okay. White and some yellow. And I'm going to make some highlights in my hair. You may need to. You find if the paint isn't sticking or is not performing, you may need to what? You may need to get the hair dryer out. Okay, and dry it to get it to work. Sometimes the biggest thing that's stopping you from achieving your goals in art is the paint being dry enough for it to work. And you'll be like, I'm just not good at this. And really, it's just you had wet paint. Look at that. Look at that. I look there, and I look there. I'm going to hate editing this later. And then I look there, and I'm going to be like mad at myself going, look at one camera. Don't jump around. Your husband is having to do a lot of work. So I'm having to take over some of these editing duties, which is great for me. I love taking on new challenges and learning new skills. Never be afraid of that. My dad's going to be skiing Mammoth downhill on an extreme slope at age 77. He would be paragliding, but he crashed that. And he was telling me how he was all mad because he was out on his KTM motorcycle, which is a bouldering Moab kind of motorcycle. Again, I say 77 GoPro. You should go check him out. And he face planted into rocks. I always love these stories to hear. My dad was out in the desert remotely where he can only be found by GPS, and he's face planting into rocks. And all the 20-year-old young extreme cyclists jumped off their bikes to help him up. And he was just like, I don't know how I feel about that. And I'm like, dude, that's respect. They love you for showing them that they are going to be on their motorcycles or their skis until age 77. They're just picking you up because you're the most awesome man out there. That's what I think. All right. So all of you were like impressed at my dad, right? I'll go 77. Yep. 77 years old. Gonna be skiing, and if you're in Mammoth and you see my dad, be like, Colby, we know what you're up to. You're skiing at 77. Better check the published date of my video or this would make no sense. All right, she's looking beautiful. We're finishing up the heart. A heart, guys. So I'm going to draw a vertical, well, it's going to be kind of in a diagonal. It's going to follow her line, but I'm going to draw a straight line, right? Straight down. And that's going to tell me the dimensions of my heart. I'm going to come up, right? You see this here? I'm going to come up and around, Have you gone by the Facebook page of Shirt Art? Have you gone in to see if our forum is working? And posted some stuff and tell us your art story. Please share your tales. You're not just really even sharing with me. You are. But I just know that you guys are much less alone than you think in what you're going through and what you're painting through and how you're coming out the other side. I think you can support each other in a really tremendous way. I love to see you guys compliment each other's artwork. There's the heart. I'm going to rinse, like you do. Okay. I'm going to get some yellow and some white on my brush. And I'm going to make this halo of energy around my heart. Okay, that's what's happening here. I might need some more white. Halo of energy. Over this yellow, I'm gonna really need some white around this heart. Maybe it's got a little blue energy. Alright, maybe that's how I'm gonna pick it up. See right there? Just some halo of energy around this heart. Story I'm telling. I just like it. You may not. You may not want to do the halo. I like the halo. She is an angel heart. Not like the movie. Just thought of that now. Not like that. Not like that at all. Oh no, I'm going to be... Maybe I should change it to heart angel so she doesn't show up on the metric. Right? We don't want her to show up with the other movie. Not that everybody didn't do a good performance, and yay, Lisa Bonet, and this is very dark, and it's not my vibe at all. It's not what I'm about at all. Nothing wrong with it. Not judging nobody. Just saying it's not me. Alright, now I'm going to highlight my heart, and then we are, guess what, wrapping up. Isn't that exciting? Got some orange going here. So I'm going to take this side and put some orange. Right here, kissing this, right this side. Kiss this side. Light and love, hope, and positivity. May good things and abundant things and blessed things be in your life. I wish you all the angels that you need to face the things you are going through. I wish you all of them. That with just that CAD. I'm going to put one little white highlight there. May your family be okay. May you be okay. If you're healing, may the things that you need to be well come to you. If you're going through loss, may the tools and resources for you to have the strength to get through that loss be available to you. I wish you everything. I love you guys so much. Click, comment, like, subscribe. Come see me. Come paint with me again. Bye-bye.